Hi folks, Luca, Shabbat Trains. Good day, Wall Street. We had a breakout of the recent high at 297.87 and reached my target 301.55 pullback. The 200 simple moving average, this red line is a big resistance, so we might hang around this area for a few more days. But if the bullish volume continues like they picked up, we could see an extension 309 and 315. The support is the 80 main, the channel bottom, currently near 3280, 282 area. Take a look at the individual stocks. So I'm going to cover all the stocks that we're following because we have a large list, about 15 plus some of those virus related, and 15 too many in the list. So I want to clear it up, keep what's working, take some profit from some that have reached targets, and then remove what's not working. All right, so let's get to it. And the first one, starting with AAL. I'm gonna also cover the day trades. Okay, so AAL, this is a new one, American Airlines. The airlines are coming off, so it's coming off the low. So things are working in this sector. Now that they're trying to reopen the economy, this is one of the industry that will is necessary to make that happen. So today we enter a position around 1060, which is my first target. This is a small resistance, 1140, very close there. My next targets are 1260, 1397, and 1538. Big resistance here at the 50. It closed above it, so that's a good indication. Volume is very bullish. The support today low and then Friday low. Abio, this comes off the list. Abio off the list. Struggling a little bit. This one was beautiful through here, a consolidation. Tried to pop on Friday, but it's obviously not ready to do that. So we may see a little more consolidation. If you continue to trade, make sure the 290 support holds. Targets 390, 361, 433, and 512 when it breaks out of this high at 357. This is now for now off the list. AMRX popped, reached my target. Volume is good, looks like it's ready for making the next move. 579 and 686. Support 450 and 420. Avio popped, reached my first target, 1048, as high as 1071. My next target, 1245 and channel top. It will be a good place to take profit. If he extends 1488, primary support 950, secondary support 850. BLDP, a new one, a breakout, spotted earlier when it was a few days ago, when it was forming this consolidation, then today popped to cut the resistance trend line and then moved above 1060, a pullback. There was a resistance at 1080, a pullback closing right at the level. Volume is good, indicates more bullish energy, hopefully, ideally coming in. The supports are today low, 1010, 1010 area, and then a Friday low, 940, 950 area. My targets, 1251, 1448, and 1660. Cruise lines. So this is Carnival. Broke out. We entered a position this day when it was around 1440, 1450, 60 area. Pressed the resistance on Friday, popped today, came as high as 1652. My first target is 1684. This high. I think we're going to get that tomorrow with this kind of volume. This is a habit of popping in the pre-market. So we may see a breakout tomorrow. And if it doesn't reach 19, peel some off. Any pullback is a good entry opportunity. The third target is 2167. This is this point. If he gets the level out. And the support 15 and 14. Circ, this was a day trader that didn't do much. And in fact, moved sideways for a good part of the day. Popped here. Press the resistance at 264 and try to break again, pull back, retest the BWP. At this point, I said this is flat, it's not doing anything. The trade doesn't always work. You know, move sideways, fine. You got a profit, take it. If you got a small loss, out. This one didn't work. CMRX, this one I'm only covering because we enter a position here. Popped is my first target, and then looks like it's ready to make the next move. Let's see if tomorrow extends. It needs to move above this high at 389, my target. 415, 508, and 592. Support is yesterday low at 320, and then Tuesday low at 320 and 3. Codex should not be here. DDD. Chemicals, this one is making a move. Popped, reached my first target today, 50.74. My second target, 53.73 and 56.48, the third target. Support tightening 48 and 47, actually 49 and 47. HAL in the oil sector, a little bit of a pop. This one was downgraded to a sell. But volume suggests, the bullish volume suggests, might want to go higher. So let's see if he gets the first target, 1281. At that point, we'll have to see. That will be a key point. It will be key resistance of this high right there, or this low, sorry. So the gap is filled and might be ready for a pullback. So we'll see if this one gets to my first target. If he doesn't, we are tightening stops, 1150. And 11, because of this reason, because of the downgrade. So sometimes they make the price drop so people can buy, institution can buy the lower price and can go higher. We'll see. The technicals are still bullish. We're not seeing a sense signal quite yet. IBO looks very good. This one is a cheapy one, but it's soon to be crossing the two. When it crosses the two, then it becomes interesting from my point of view. But if you ended up trading this one, congratulations, already hit my first target at 168. This week over here when was one. That was a big move. Consolidation, testing the channel bottom. If this thing gets going, 242, 338, and possibly five mid-channel. The support is the ATMA near 140, and then the secondary support is this low on Friday, last Friday, 116, 110. IFRX, this one comes off the list. Had a big volume a few days ago, but it's not moving. It's moving sideways, it's holding the support, but we already have a large list. So I'm trying to get rid of some that are not performing at the moment. This one is the target, 8.11, but needs more module to get going. If it does, my second target is 9.36, 10.83, and 12.29. By the way, the fact that I'm taking them off the list doesn't mean that you have to close a position. As long as hold the trend channel, hold the ATMA, this is true for any stock, stay long. As long as you're comfortable and support holds, this, as much as I know, can go, 15. We'll see. The support is 750. I know today popped, reached the target at 1507 actually, one penny, two penny shy of it. Volume is coming in now. The vaccine kind of stocks today took a dive, including Moderna, we'll cover in a moment. This will make a pop, made a pop, but stalled. So but we don't want this to turn into an inverted hammer and price going lower. So it needs to move above 15. We have two tight stops, 14 and 13. Next targets, if it gets going, 17, 20, and 19, 30. Iowa, this one, I'm not happy about it. This is off the list. So we entered a position on Friday, made a good move. The position was around 39, 50, 40. Reached the first resistance at 41, 13. Then the pre-market popped a little bit, as you can see right here. And but stall around the 42 area and then immediately came down very hard. And this is a sell signal. This is a bearish engulfing with a downward volume increase. This is off the list. Myrna was a fantastic trade through there. Broke out, vaccine 93, major reversal. Actually, this is a short now. So the technicals were all bullish through here. And then we had two tight stops. We attempted the re-entry around 69. But broke the support around 70, broke the support 69, 67, and 65. With these two move, this is done. Broke the channel bottom, most likely we're gonna come down to 54 and test it 34 EMA. This is gonna make some three-way corrective because before it makes the next move to the upside. If it does, number volume increase suggests it wants to go lower. Be careful if you are trading this one. For us, obviously off the list. Save, a day trade that worked nicely. I didn't frankly expect to move past 1175. But did. So a good pop with huge volume consolidation right at the opening. Good consolidation. This is what I want to see. Nice consolidation sideways cross the VWP. Hold. Usually this is an indication that wants to go higher. Pop reached my first target, 12, 13. Pull back, retest at the channel bottom, the VWP, and then extended to a resistance trend line at 1250, and it was done at that point. This is in the airlines. The airlines are coming off the low. So there is a possibility for an extension. For us, again, this was just a day trade, so that's it. But very strong move today. Volume is great. If this one extends, 1340, 1480, 1660, 1872. The support is today low at 1120. SE continues to move. If you're trading this one, I never gave you an entry alert, but we cover several times in case you're trading it. I reached my next target, 82. I keep tightening the stops, 78, 75. The next target, 86, 91, and 96 channel top. Just broke out of this mid channel. This could accelerate going vertical. 78 and 75, yes. This one is an oil company. I like it. It's forming a base. Looks like it's ready to break. There is a big gap up here. I will trade it carefully, but this is not in the list by any means. It's just here because I'm using it as a gauge. There is a resistance at 1923. If it breaks above it, there is a big gap to be filled all the way up to 23. That's $4. Good profit to be making with this one if volume comes in. I like the action. I like this pendant. And the support is 17. And then the blue line down to 1560. Moves fast, so be careful with that if you trade it. Again, this is not the list, nothing to do with that. SRNE, this was something that we attempted to trade in the pre-market when it popped with big volume. This was in the pre-market watch list. Popped right here, extended. My first target was 649, came as high as 634, and then I pulled back. Usually when you have this kind of move, looks like generally wants to go higher. A big pop, huge volume. No, I didn't have a huge volume. The huge volume came right at the open and then came down very hard. We had two tight stops because this moved very fast, 550 and 5. This last week was incredible, made the move from 4 in 2 days to 10. So the technicals are bullish. From the daily chart, volume is picking up. I like this overlook of the chart. Looks like a breakout. The bottom line, 5 needs to hold. Yes, Friday low, 465 needs to hold. If he consolidates and makes a move above today high, my first target is 649. Above that, 753, 877, and 10. Surf, this one was a fantastic swing last week. Beautiful, 100% in 1 day, in 2 days. And it's pulling back on low volume. I like the look of it. To keep an eye. If it comes down to 4, that's a good buy opportunity, I think. Good consolidation. And then if he at some point breaks out of this resistance trend line, which is forming a triangle, my target 619, 758, and 9. Uber popped today, stall at 36. In the pre-market was 36, that's the resistance, as well as in the regular session. My second target, 37 and 40, 46. We are tightening stops, 34 and 32. The number volume picked up a little bit, but the chart is still bullish. So stay long until you see a sell signal, which will be a lower movement tomorrow and a number volume increase. The XRT, this was one of the virus-related stocks that wasn't working through here, and then popped, reached the target, and then pulled back, and is still struggling. So this off the list. For this one to work, it's going to come back above 344. And then if in that case, 411, 5, 6, off the list. And finally, Wharf popped today. Volume is coming, very good. Not a great close, but close above the key resistance of 32.15. Actually, sorry, 32.50. Why is a key resistance? Because it's been stalling all along through the area. And finally broke out, came off the moving average, the ATMA, made a high of 33.29 a pullback. This moves very fast, so be aware of these fluctuations. Came down to 29, immediately reversed, and here is going up again. So I'm looking for 34. This was my first target, 32. 15, 34, 19, 36, 57, and I think we get to 39. That will be the fourth target. All right, folks, thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow with trading.